It is emergency legislation, and I've no problem with that. We have no problem with the fact that we're having to sit late to get it through. But it is because Brexit will threaten businesses and trade, and that there is a clear need for some provisions. But we are moving heaven and earth yet again to respond to a crisis. And I think some people in the country will find parallels to the hurried rush legislation that were put through this House in 2008 to banks, albeit over 2 weeks rather than two nights. I'm not arguing that this isn't an emergency, nor that this bill isn't necessary, but I think we should look at what it does and look carefully at what it does. It raises from €500,000 to over €7 million the grants available to businesses affected under Enterprise Ireland and the IDA. It covers up tax loopholes and tax credit facilities for businesses that might be affected by Brexit, so that they can continue to avail of our flawed tax codes for corporations and tax capital gains tax. And it clearly flies in the face of much of the dogma that we have seen forced down our throats in recent decades of what the state can and can't do to interfere with the market, because we're constantly told the state cannot interfere with enterprise, it cannot interfere with the markets, but here we are interfering in a very forthright manner. In the words of the Minister, the bill seeks to safeguard our state and its institutions. So, the question I'd like to put is, if this is how we respond to an emergency, could we see, and I would dearly love to see it, single-minded determination by this state, by you, Minister, and by everybody in your government to rush through emergency legislation to deal with the other emergencies we face, the housing emergency, the climate emergency? Why can't the state move heaven and earth to invest in state-owned institutions to deal with those emergencies? And I think we must look at where this crisis originates from, because it really is a crisis of the British state. And it is particularly a crisis of a section of the Tory party who whipped up anti-immigration sentiment and nationalism, the worst kind of nationalism, British nationalism, in order to stem the growth of the support that was rising for Corbyn and Corbyn's section of the Labour Party and to safeguard their own positions. This is a battle within the British ruling class of two competing blocs in Britain, and indeed it's all about a decaying British empire on which the sun doesn't even rise anymore, but it is a decaying empire that's trying to reposition itself inside global capitalism and to be able to compete with Brussels, with Paris and with Berlin and make the city of London great again. I come from a political tradition that used to raise the slogan during the Cold War, neither Washington nor Moscow, but international socialism. And the slogan today would rightly fit with neither London nor Brussels, but with workers across Britain and across Europe. And I say this because both in Britain and in the European Union, the movers and the shakers of this crisis have no real interest in the lives of ordinary people or how their machinations affect their lives. The main issue for us is that this bill does nothing or says nothing about the implementation of a hard border. It says nothing about taking measures that could stop a border being imposed on us by the European Union, whom, despite what he said here in Parliament over a year ago, Michel Barnier and Jean-Claude Juncker have no guarantee that they will not try to implement a hard border in this country. It says no declaration by the Irish state what they will do, what this government will do in the event of a hard border being imposed on us. It doesn't offer, for example, services to women from Northern Ireland for abortion, something that we are proud of having achieved down here. And after the referendum was passed, the first slogan to be chanted across the Yard of Dublin Castle was, "The North is next." But we have nothing to say to those tens of thousands of women in the North who are trapped without abortion services. It doesn't say anything about building the kind of infrastructure that's needed to link the north and south, like decent railway lines between Dublin and Derry and Donegal and Derry. It says nothing about the environment and the types of changes that we need to make to ensure that we battle climate change in a meaningful and effective manner. Indeed, it says nothing about the proposal by the Tory government to dump nuclear waste on the peninsula in County Down. And that is a very, very serious threat by the Tory government. I think, Minister, the bottom line is that if there is a hard border imposed on this country, either by the Tories, by a hard Brexit, or by the Tories refusing to do a deal, or indeed by the European Union insisting that there is one, it behoves this government to declare that we will have no truck with it. We will not implement a border by using civil servants, by using Gardaí, by using customs posts, or any software or online equivalent that might try to track whatever happens on the border. And therefore, it behoves us to say that the best solution to a hard border is to have no border, and that means giving the people, north and south, a vote on the outcome of whatever deal or no deal happens. The people of this island did not vote for a hard Brexit. They did not ask for it. And in that case, they need to have a democratic vote on the outcome of whatever happens. I think the last thing I'd like to say about the question of the Brexit is that it is absolutely legitimate to be sceptical of the European Union and at the same time to be against a hard Brexit, because what it would do in this country is unthinkable. If a border appeared again in this country, having been 20 years since the Good Friday Agreement and the progress that's been made since then, it is unthinkable. And it behoves this government to have a response to that. And I believe the best response is to look to the people for people power to oppose a hard border and to give them the vote in the first instance. And if there's any attempt to physically impose it, to mount a mass movement in opposition to it, a movement like was mounted in opposition to the water charges, to defeat an attempt to implement such a hard border.
Thank you very much, Deputy Smith.